Good morning. Good morning. What an on-time song. Happy Friday, people of the Most High God. This is Rise and Pray. Lives depend on it. A great big welcome to our returning callers. And for those joining us for the very first time, we are here Monday through Friday starting at 5:55, which starts our praise and worship. And at 6 a.m. to 6:15, we come to you with a war cry focus. Our prayer line number is 712-451-0200. Please like us on Facebook, subscribe to the YouTube channel, and follow us on Instagram. Prayer is essential. It's a time to travail for the nation and our family members like never before. We pray that you are blessed by these prayers and that your faith is being strengthened. In order to pray prayers that get the ear of God, we must apply His word. You can't apply your faith if you do not know His word. So let us build our faith. We're going into Luke 16, 19 to 31 in the Message Bible. Luke 16, 19 to 31, the rich man and Lazarus. There once was a rich man expensively dressed in the latest fashion, wasting his days in conspicuousness. Consumption. A poor man named Lazarus, covered with sores, had been dumped on his doorstep. All he lived for was to get a meal from scraps off the rich man's table. His best friends were the dogs who came and licked his sores. Then he died. This poor man was taken up by the angels to the lap of Abraham. The rich man also died and was buried. In hell and in torment, he looked up and saw Abraham in the distance and Lazarus in his lap. He called out, "Father Abraham, mercy. Have mercy. Send Lazarus to dig his finger in water to cool my tongue. I am in agony in this fire." But Abraham said, "Child, remember that in your lifetime you got the good things and Lazarus the bad things. It's not like that here. Here he is consoled and you're tormented. Besides, in all these matters, there's a huge chasm set between us so that no one can go from us to you, even if he wanted to, nor can anyone cross over from you to us." These are my scriptures, my baseline scriptures, 27 to 31. The rich man said, "Then let me ask you, Father, send him to the house of my father where I have five brothers, so he can tell them the score and warn them so they won't end up here in this place of torment." Abraham answered, "They have Moses and the prophets to tell them the score. Let them listen to them." "I know, Father Abraham," he said, but they're not listening. If someone came back to them from the dead, they would change their ways." Abraham replied, "If they won't listen to Moses and the prophets, they're not going to be convinced by someone who rises from the dead." Father Abraham told the rich man, "Let them listen to Moses and the prophets. We are the generation that is called to witness to the lost, called to proclaim the good news to whomever will hear it. Death comes for all. There's a heaven to be embraced and a hell to be shunned. All human beings will experience one or the other for eternity. This is what makes the church gospel mission so vital. We must do all we can to win people to faith in Christ, for at the grave it will be too late. But many of us have become fatigued in 2020. Financial despair, emotional baggages, and death has knocked at our door. Fatigue saps our enthusiasm and our motivation. With such a vast need in this world, some of us don't even know where to start, and other of us are spread too thin, helping wherever we can. I admonish us as God's chosen people. We can't stop sharing the good news. Don't get tired, saints. Don't give up hope. There is a God, your Abba, Father. We want to pray that God will give us all grit. To have grit means you have courage and show the strength of your character. A person with true grit has passion and perseverance. Goals are set and follow through. A person who works really hard to follow through on commitments has true grit. It is not a word you hear very often, but we need it to proclaim the good news. Our strategies need to change. Our passion for souls has to be ignited like never before, that we can be the conduit to deliver those who have the heart of the rich man and those that scoff at the word of God. Our war cry focus today is, it's not the time to become spiritually fatigued. Pour out the oil of grit. It's not the time to become spiritually fatigued. Pour out the oil of grit. Dear gracious and eternal Father, we thank you for the oil of grit, God. God, we ask you right now as we bow our heads, Father God, and acknowledge you as Lord and Savior, that you will start to anoint each and every one of us on the line, on social media, that we can have grit, Father God, to face the challenges ahead, God. Give us clear understanding, God, as we have to understand the times and the season we are living in, God. You pulled us out of darkness into your marvelous light, Father God, that we could proclaim the good news, God. So, Father, we need confidence on today, Father, for we are more than enough. You are our inheritance. You are our possessions. You are I am that I am, God. For you are God, and your ways are higher than man's, God. Show us your way. Show us the mind of Christ. Put your words into the mouth of your believers on this season, God. Put your thoughts into the minds of the believers on this season. Let us not speak heresies, God. Help us to avoid foolish babbling. Help us to see truth and turn away from deception and lies. We let go of that sin that so easily besets us in this season, God. We can no longer be caught up between two opinions, God. We got to choose life in this season. We got to choose Christ in this season. We declare and decree we are not lukewarm Christians in this season. We are on fire for the gospel, on fire for the word of God, on fire for the souls, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Father, consume our iniquities, God. Forgive us for everything we said or did that was not pleasing in your sight, Daddy God. Purify us with hyssop and wash us and make us clean through our though our sins are red like crimson, Father. Forgive us for catering to our bodily pleasures and appetites that don't profit a thing, God. We denounce the things of this world, God, and we become heavenly minded. We let go of our passions, Daddy God. Forgive us for thinking riches are a sign of blessing and favor, God. It is our stewardship, God, stewardship of what you have given us that commands the blessing and favor, God. For whom is much is given, much is required, God. We let go of our isms and schisms on this season. We let go of jealousy and envy and hate, God. We let go of the need to control others and the situation. We denounce every seducing spirit, and we let go of idolatry in this season. We command anger and hate to leave the nation in the name of Jesus. We command the spirit of love and kindness to take root in the hearts of your people, God. Father, we need community transformation, God. Father, we need you to remove the chaos in our nations, God. Father, we need you to remove any unproductive energy right now in the name of Jesus. We tell the spirit of mental illness to go, God. In the name of Jesus, we lift up those who are dangerously tired, God. And we speak a refreshing wind to come upon them, God. Those that have been protesting for social justice and reform, God. Our police officers and our essential workers, God. Our teachers and the students, God. We ask you to strengthen them, God. We thank you for the inequalities will be reversed in the bosom of Abraham, God. We thank you that there's going to be a reversing, God. Reversing because the first shall be the last and the last shall be the first. We enter into a season that things are getting ready to be reversed, God. Oh, God, I feel the Holy Ghost with that one. There's a deep-seated anger in our nation, Daddy, God. And so we got to bring it before you because we don't know what to do, God. So we ask you to remove it. And can you clear up all this anguish, God, in the name of Jesus, God, that we can hear your spirit clearly, God. Help us not to let anger lead us, God, but let the Holy Spirit guide us, God, into the next dimension of you, God. In the name of Jesus, we ask that truth will prevail, God. In the name of Jesus, we ask you to give us ears to hear what the Spirit of God is saying, God. We thank you that it's going to get better. We apply our faith on today, our faith that moves mountains, God. We thank you for the peace that surpasses all understanding on this day, God. We glorify you for helping us see that we are enough, God. We are King's kid, and no weapon formed against us, God, shall prosper in the name of Jesus. And we thank you, God, that you know all things, God. You are in control of it all, God. You are the I am that I am. You are the true one. You are the resurrected life, God. The one who died and rose on the third day. So we thank you for the blood of Jesus, God, that washes us and makes us white as snow, God, in the name of Jesus. So we ask you, God, today to deal with the fatigue that we feel, God. We're tired of seeing so much. We're tired of this coronavirus. We're tired, Father God, of the evil that we see, God, and it's making us fatigue, God, and we need grit, God. We got to fight against principalities and powers, God. So we thank you for you shaking us up, God. We thank you for you putting our fire under our circumstances and our situations, even in our own very household, God. We thank you that we're not going to idolize anything and anyone, God. That we're seeking the kingdom of God. We're seeking the righteousness of God. We're seeking you, God, in the name of Jesus. All we want is Jesus, Jesus, Jesus in this season, God. We thank you for the disruption. We thank you for shifting our thought process, shifting our relationships, shifting our institutional mind, shifting our family dynamics, shifting our ministries, God. This is a season for your word to be manifested. Heal our mental state. Heal our mental fatigue. Heal us, God, in the name of Jesus. We cast out weariness. We rebuke exertion, God. Take away the heaviness we're feeling. Take away the hopelessness. Take away the boredom, God. Take away the lack of interest, God. Give us firmness of character. Give us bravery, God, in the name of Jesus. Pour the oil of perseverance, God. Pour the oil of toughness. Pour the oil of courage, God. Pour the oil of fortitude, God. Pour the oil of tenaciousness. Pour the oil of warring spirit, God. Oh, God, give us faith, God, to fight the good fight, God. We shall not get fatigued in the times of trouble and distress. We call on the ministering angels of the Most High, God, God. When we get weary, remind us of your word, Daddy. Remind us of the apostles and the prophets. Remind us of Father Abraham. We lift up the scoffers before you, God. We lift up those who have an assignment to speak evil of the things of God. We denounce deception, God. We denounce fear, God. We denounce hypocrisy, God, in the name of Jesus. For we are the true sons and daughters of the Most High, God. We are King's kid, God. In the name of Jesus, we pray for those who lost a loved one on this week. We pray for those who will bury the dead this weekend. Give them hope, God, in the name of Jesus. Show them your promises. We pray for those in ICU. We tell God the spirit of infirmity to leave their body, unclog the lungs, unclog the respiratory systems in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, God. We pray for
persecution, God. We pray for those who are lukewarm Christians, God. We pray against this racial divide, God, in the blessed name of Jesus. We are not ashamed of the gospel. We declare and decree it's not the time to get spiritually fatigued. Father, we ask you to pour the oil of grit that for the edification of the body and bring hope and salvation to the nations. We are full of grit and tenacity. We are stronger than ever. Our faith is secure in the blood that was shed in Calvary. Remember, strengthen your faith and don't get spiritually fatigue. May the word of the Lord be a blessing to the hearers and the doers of his most holy word. In Jesus' name we do pray. Amen and amen. Have a blessed weekend.